Here we go with another shout out Monday evening, and today is March 26, 2018, and today's acronym is some Arduino. So let's get going with this right now. Hi, I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. I do these shout outs every Monday, so you, as the model railroader, can learn new things about model railroading. And today's subject is going to be on Arduino, and we're going to do quite a few videos on that subject in the future after we finish up two videos on the instant buildings that are coming out this week on Tuesday and Wednesday. I had so much footage on it that it took up two videos. So Tuesday is part one and Wednesday will be part two. So look for that, and the Arduino will be on Saturday. So what is that acronym that we're talking about? Some Arduino. Now, if you can imagine some Arduino, that's going to be a doozy, so I got to read this one off here. Shout out Monday evening. Any real developer understands initializing normal objectives. And if you know anything about coding, then you'll understand that. Or I should have said objects. But anyway, that's what we're going to talk about today, Arduino, right after this. If you would like to see more videos like this on model railroading and shoutouts and Arduino, electronic projects, everything about model railroading, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell so you can be notified whenever I have a new video coming out. And go check out the playlist page down there. I have a lot of playlists, over 40 of them, categorized in subjects for you to find easily. So go to that playlist page, look up the categories that I have that you're interested in, and go and watch those videos. There's a lot of good information there. So let's get started with this right now. The first thing we're going to take a look at today is the Arduino webpage, which is www.arduino.cc. It's an Italian company, and they originally produced Arduinos for educating young children. So it's going to be an easy task to work on these things. And everything that you want to know about Arduino is on their webpage, even education, resources. They have getting started tutorials. They have these tutorials on here on different subjects, the foundations and more, examples from libraries, built-in examples, and I'll show you some built-in examples and references. All the coding that is used in Arduino sketches is right here. And if you have any issues with it, you just go on there. I'll do one of the first ones, digital read, which you'll be seeing a lot. And it gives you an explanation of what it is and example code. And you could also go on the IDE for Arduino and get example code there also. But let me bring up online tools. Okay, right here. They also have a web editor. And I'll bring this up real quick. You could use the web editor, or you could bring up the IDE on your computer as well. But since we got right here, I'm going to do the web editor real quick. I'll show you examples, basics, and blink. This is what is loaded on every Arduino, just a short sketch to blink an LED on there, just to show you that it is working. Normally it gives you a little bit of explanation right here of what everything is, and the code starts right here with the void setup. And we're not going to get into that right now, but I just wanted you to see that you can get to it from your web browser. And here are some of the things that you're going to need. First off is we're going to be using a Arduino Uno. Now this one was made by Make, and I have quite a few things that are made by Make. Here's a project board right here, which has a couple of extra LEDs, a couple of push buttons, so, and a potentiometer, where you could set this thing up on top of it, and we'll go through some of that, those things later on. But this is called a shield. Now I have another shield here. This is a relay shield. Unfortunately, Arduino only works with 3.3 and 5 volts. So if you need to operate anything higher than 5 volts, you're going to need a shield, a relay, either a relay shield or a relay board. They both do the same thing. They both have 4 relays on it. This one, you just hook it up to your Arduino, hook up the jumpers to the specific pins, and you're on your way to operate things that work with higher than 5 volts. I have a new Arduino here still in the package. You're going to need a breadboard with some jumper wires like these right here, or if you like to make your own, you could buy these boxes of jumper wire. This is 22 gauge solid wire. You get 25 foot in each roll, and you got different colors there, and you can make your own jumper wires so you don't have these big ones all over the board. Now, anytime you get a shield, say like this one, the relay shield, you get a little information about it. This was one was from Seed Studio, which I bought a long time ago, and it works pretty well. And this does the same thing. It's got 4 relays on there. You put your outputs on here. This is your inputs that go onto your Arduino board. And that's all you're going to need, and the enthusiasm and ideas of what you want to do with your model railroad. But anyway, let's get back up to here and go back to, they have a forum, blogs, they have project hubs where people, the things that they built with Arduinos. And the one good thing about Arduinos is that everything on here is open source. The board is open source. You could go on the Arduino website and you could download the schematic for this and build your own. And that's what we're going to do. I have one of the chips for it, and I had to get it through SparkFun because it's got the bootloader on it. You want to get one with the bootloader if you want to make your own Arduino. But if you get it directly from Arduino, I think it's like $22. If you get it from another source, you can get them as cheap as $10. And then they got the Pro, Mini, and the Nano ones that are real small, about half the size of this right here, about that big right there, where you could do the same thing as you can on an Uno. So we're going to have some fun with building these projects on here. And this is the same thing as the web browser IDE. And you can go over to examples and basics, and we'll go over to Blink right here. And this is the same thing that we brought up on the web browser. And let's expand this a little bit. And with the explanation, same exact thing. And comes down here to the actual code and what you could do. Whenever you need any kind of code on here, you just go to the examples, and that's a starting place. And if it isn't if you can't find it in the examples, they have, let me see what else we got here. This is one of the ones. This one right here is by Jeff Bunza, and this one is for the 17 servos. To operate the 17 servos. He did an explanation of this in Model Railroad Hobbyist magazine, showing the 17 servos on there. But this is so good that you could go online and find anything that you want. You just Google what you want, Arduino servo sketch, and you'll find all kind of servo sketches that you want. So this is what we're going to be talking about starting out on Saturday. We're going to do our first one, and then throughout the month of April we'll be doing some Arduino and some other things, but we're going to get familiar with Arduino and some sketches, and we're going to do some projects, and I'm going to show you how to do the same project that I showed you how to dim the lights. We're going to do it right on here, and you're going to see how easy it is. So take a look for that and leave a comment down below if you want. Now, I got a lot of people that already asked for sketches on servos so they could operate their switch machines, so they could use a servo as a switch machine. So there we go. But if you have any questions and want any kind of projects, let me know. Leave a comment down below so we could find some sketch that we could work on, so we could figure it out on our own right here. I might even, if you persuade me, I might even do a live one on Arduino. Check that out. It's coming out. Check out Arduino webpage, arduino.cc. They have everything that you want to know about Arduino right there. And other things, Spark Fun, Adafruit, Make, all those web pages. They have projects on there. They have products on there that you could buy. And there's more than that. I mean, even this one right here, this one I bought about 4 years ago when I bought my first Arduino. It's a relay board, and it's Seed Studio. I don't even know if they're still available. S-E-E-E-D. But I didn't even think about looking them up. But anyway, every shield out there is also open source. So if you buy one, you go onto their website, you can see the wiring diagram for that shield. So that's the good thing about it. Everything is open source. The shields and the sketches and the Arduino boards itself and everything that all the manufacturers make to fit on and work with the Arduino is all open source. So you can copy it, improve on it, make your own. There's even tutorials out there where you could even make your own project boards. And I got this one from Make a few years ago, and it comes just a plain board, and they give you all the parts, and you have to solder all the parts onto it, which gives you a little bit of experience with soldering on a circuit board. But anyway, check that out. Check out the Arduino page. We're going to have some fun with it. And so we'll see you later on. Remember, Tuesday and Wednesday, I got instant buildings. And then Saturday, I got the first Arduino video coming out. So we'll see you.